हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ श्रद्धा सदावर्ते, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, सूर्योदय कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. नाउ टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक इज इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एक्ट 2000. द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक आर इंट्रोडक्शन, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द आईटी एक्ट 2000, डिजिटल सिग्नेचर एंड सर्टिफिकेट्स, ई कॉमर्स एंड ई गवर्नेंस, ऑफेंसेस एंड पेनल्टीज, साइबर क्राइम, केस स्टडीज एंड व्हाट इज द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ दिस एक्ट, स्कोप ऑफ दिस एक्ट एंड लास्टली अमेंडमेंट ऑफ द आईटी एक्ट. नाउ फर्स्टली वी सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द आईटी एक्ट. इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इज द वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉ रिलेटेड टू द इंडियन साइबर लॉ. नाउ दिस लॉ इज पास इन द ईयर 2000. Also, it has consist of 13 chapters and 4 schedules. This act is helpful to promote your business with the help of internet. It is also the set of rules, regulations, and also which is apply on electronic business transaction. Now, due to the increasing of cyber crime space, government of India understood the problem of internet user for safeguarding the internet. Of interest of internet user, this act was made. Now next is that the object. What is the objective of this act? The first objective of this act is the act is give bigger recognition to any transaction which is done by electronic way or use of internet. Now the second objective is that. To give the legal recognition to the digital signature for accepting any agreement via computers. Next is that according to the IT Act, any company can store their data in electronic storage. Next is that to stop the cyber crime or protect your private data for the internet users. Now next is that to provide the facility of filling document online relating to the school admission, registration, scholarship form, etc. This act can be used. Now next is that to give the legal recognition for keeping books of accounts by bankers and other companies in electronic form. To make more power to IPO, RBI and Indian evidence for restricting electronic crime. So these are the objective of this IT Act 2000. Now next is that what is the structure of the IT Act? The IT Act consists of total 13 chapters and which is divided into 94 sections. Now the chapter 1 to chapter 8 are mostly digital signature related. And the chapter 9 and chapter to the chapter 13 are regarding penalties, offenses, etc. Also, it includes that the 4 schedules, which is amendment in respect to the certain other acts. So this is the structure of the IT Act 2000. Next is that what is digital signature? As per information. As per IT Act 2000, digital signature means authentication of any electronic record by means of an electronic. That is the simple, in simple language, it is a simply signature, simply your signature in digital form. Then this is known as digital signature. Now, how to verify your digital signature or how to change your simple signature into digital signature. Suppose first we see the diagram of this signing and verification processes. Suppose we give one data, then convert this data into hash function, that is in a proper format given by the government. Now hash the data, then encrypt your data by using the private keys. Now next step is that the certificate and the signature attached to the given data and your data is digitally signed. Now the verification process is that your digital signature data is divided into 2 parts. Firstly, the data is separated and signature is separated. Then hash function is applied to this data. Then we give a hash function document, and in the other side, the signature describe the signature using public key. Again, we give the hash function. If the hashes are equal, then your signature is valid. This is the procedure for verification of digital signature. Now, let's see that digital signature certificate. If you have a digital signature, then we give a government to the digital signature certificate. What is the digital signature certificate? With everything going digital or online, every signature has in digital version, commonly known as digital signature certificate, or also it is known as DSC. Next is that with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, income tax authorities and goods and service tax are already accepting online documents. Now the taxpayer are now mandatorily required to the sign document digitally with the help of DSC only. Next is that your digital signature certificate is normally valid for the 1 to 2 years, and after that year we can renew the your digital signature certificates. Next is that what is the benefits of digital signature certificate? The first benefit is that authenticity of your document. Second is that reduce your time or reduce your cost. And third is that data integrity. These are the benefits of your digital signature certificate or DSC. Next is that what is e-governance? Now the e-governance means it is application of the information technology to the process of government functioning about smart. Next is that moral. That is moral is that means it is concerned with what is your right or what is your wrong. Next is accountable. Now accountable means to give an explanation of your action, responsive, and lastly transparent government. This is the e-government. Now, what is the benefits of your e-governance? The first benefits is that it is greater convenience to all the peoples. Next is that cost reduction. Now, third is as revenue growth. And next is that less corruption, increased transparency. These are the benefits of e-governance. Now, next topic is that electronic commerce or e-commerce. Now the e-commerce is generally used or refers to all the activities related to the purchase and the sales of goods and services. That is marketing, sales, payment, fulfillment, shopping, customer service, etc. Also, electronic commerce is doing commerce with the use of computer network or commerce-enabled software. That is, in that features, we can mostly use just online shopping, more than online shopping. Now the features of the, what is the features of e-commerce? The first feature is that online business advertisement or anytime anywhere is used, service direct contact between buyers and sellers, reduction of your cost or reduce your money, medium of interaction, expand the business. These are the features of e-commerce. Now, what is the penalties and exemption of the IT Act 2000? The first is that the section, these are the most important section in your IT Act. The first section is that section number 42. In that section, if any person or owner or any person in charge damage the computer or computer system or computer network, he shall be liable to penalty and compensation of such person so affected. In section 44, return report to the controller or certifying authentic authority, then he shall be liable to pay penalty up to rupees 1 lakh rupees per failure. Now next is that further where a person fails to furnish any information, books or other document within time specified, then he shall be liable to pay penalty up to rupees 5000 per day. Also the next is that further the person fails to maintain book for accounts or any other record, then he shall be liable to pay penalty up to rupees 10,000 per day. Now the penalties and offences in the IT Act. So first, these are the most important section in the IT Act 2000. The section one is section 65. In that section consists of tampering with any computer source code, use of computer program or computer system, computer network. Then the punishment in that section for this crime, the punishments is that jail or custody up to 3 years or with the fine up to extended to the 2 lakh rupees. Next section is the section 67. In section 67 included that publishing, transmitting information which is offenses in electronic form shall be punished. The punishment is that also custody for the 3 years or fine which may be extended to the 5 lakh rupees. Also custody to the 5 years, either 5 years and fine will be extended to the 10 lakh rupees. These are the punishment for this section. Now next is that section 72. Any person who has accessed any electronic record, book, register, correspondence, information document or any other material without the consent to the concerned person, so that the crime, the punishment is that custody for the 2 years or fine which may be extended to the 1 lakh rupees or both. Now the punishment for publishing digital signature certificate falls in certain particular. The punishment is that for this crime, custody or jail for the 2 years or fine which may be extended to the 1 lakh rupees or both can be applicable. Next is that the cyber crime under the Indian IT laws. What is, first we see what is the cyber crime. Criminals can operate anonymously over the computer network. Hackers invade privacy. Hackers destroy property in the form of computer or files or records. Also, computer pirates steal intellectual property. First crime is that financial property. In that crime included that cheating, credit card frauds, money laundering. These can be crimes are included in the financial crimes. Next is cyber pornography. The cyber pornography included pornography website, pornography magazine produced using computers and the internet. These are included in the cyber pornography. Now next is that web jacking. This occurs when someone forcefully take control of your website or cracking the password and later changing it. These the crimes are included in the web jacking. Now also it has included in the phishing, online gambling, email spoofing. These are the included in the web jacking. Now next is a crime is that intellectual property crimes. This included software piracy, copyright infringement, trademarks violations, theft of computer source code, etc. are included in that crime. Now the copyrights, software piracy means when your data, for example, for the when you download a copy of my software, this can be you crime included in the software piracy. Also copyright is that downloading from a file, sharing without website using paying for it. Also you can download the movie or music without proper payment for this. These are the crimes are included in the intellectual property crimes. In cyber crimes also the most of the criminals are kids, that is the for the age of 9 to 16 years, organized activists, disgruntled employees, professional hackers. These are being included in the cyber crimes. Now what is the case or case study for this IT Act? The first is case is that under section 65 a case is registered as one person versus state of Andhra Pradesh. In this case, the Tata Indicom employees were arrested for manipulating of the electronic 32-bit number program into a cell phone theft, were exclusively furnished to Reliance Infocom. Now the wording is that court held that tampering with the source code under section 65 and it is the applicable for the punishment for this section of IT Act 2000. Now the next is Ahmedabad blast. He also included in the case study of the IT Act. Now what is the advantages of the IT Act? The first advantage is that it is helpful to promote e-commerce. Second is that to enhance the corporate business. Third is that high penalty for cyber crimes. Next is that it is used for the online forms, filling online forms. Also, it has significantly lowered the transaction cost. Also, 24/7 services available. Now, next is that it is easily available to all the people. Easily available all the people for any time, anywhere. Also, it is a digital signature is valid. And last is that payment via credit card is valid. This, etc. These are the advantages are included in the IT Act 2000. Now, scope of the IT Act. First scope is that Information Technology Act is not applicable on the attestation for creating trust via electronic way. That is means that the for this date, physical attestation is also must. Now, second is that IT Act 2000 is not applicable on the attestation for making will of anybody. Also, that is physical attestation by two witnesses is must. Now, next scope of the IT Act is contract of sale of any immovable property. And last is that attestation for giving power of attorney of property is not possible via electronic record. So these are the scopes these are the scope of the IT Act 2000. Now lastly is that amendment of the IT Act 2000. Now the amendment of the IT Act 2000 is amended in the year 2008, that is notified 27th October 2008. In that the amendment the law of IT Act 2000 is amended for these features are as follows. That is, first is electronic signature. Now next is examiner of electronic evidences. Also 8 new cyber crimes or cyber offenses act. Also power of anticipation of electronic communication to the government, database security and privacy. And lastly is that the level of investigation brought down to the inspector from the DSP, etc. These are the included amendment included in the IT Act. So these are the presentation of the IT Act 2000, and these are the references we can use prepare this presentation of the IT Act 2000. Lastly, we have to thank the management and principal sir, vice principal sir, to give me opportunity to share this PPT for the student, also everyone. So lastly, thank you so much.